So, okay students, welcome back to the today's session of Elements of Civil Engineering. So, in the previous class, we are discussing about the some of the types of support reaction and different types of supports, different types of beams, columns, and the type of loads which is coming on the beam. So we have already discussed these some of the numericals, that is simple problems on the support reaction. So in the today's class, so let me solve some more problems which is related to the support reaction. So you can observe this is what the problem which is available, that is determine the support reaction at the point A and B, so that is A and E, for a given beam as shown in figure. So this is what the given beam. So for this beam, you need to find out what is the support reaction. So here you need to write the number of reactions based on the support here. So you can observe, this is what the, which type of support it is, hinged support. So you can observe, this is the hinged support. For hinged support, how many reactions? How many reactions we can observe for the hinged support? How many reactions for the hinged support? So hinged support, I have given in the example of a door. So we can rotate the door, but horizontal moment and vertical moment of the support is not possible. So for hinged support, we are having the two reaction, that is one is horizontal and one is vertical. So and roller support. So since roller support can allow the moment in the horizontal direction and rotation is also possible. So what is impossible? Vertical moment is impossible. Therefore, we are getting the one vertical reaction because of the roller support. So they have not mentioned here simply supported beam. So they have mentioned that is hinged support as well as the roller support. For hinged support, two reactions. So you can give any name. So it is at point A, you can give it as RAX. Similarly, you can give it is RAY. So similarly, you can here, you can give R into E is the support reaction at point E. So now the support reaction is over, you need to draw the free body diagram in which the number of forces acting on a beam should be shown. So 100 kilonewton is a force, that is point load, and 200 is an inclined force. So inclined force is nothing but we are getting the two forces, that is one is horizontal component and one is vertical component. So horizontal component is 200 cos 45 and vertical component is 200 sin 45, just the resolution. So here UDL is there, that is uniformly varying load is there here. So that is, in order to convert this UDL into point load, we are multiplying the magnitude. Magnitude is nothing but 20 into span where it is acting, that is 3. 20 into 3, that is 60 is a point load. And where we need to show? We need to show exactly at the center of this span, that is 1.5 meter from B and 1.5 meter from C. So now the number of forces which is acting on a beam along with the support reaction, so you need to show in this as a free body diagram. You can observe hinged support is there, so therefore two reactions, and here we are having the roller support, so therefore we are having only one reaction. And number of forces 100 kilonewton as it is you need to write, and this is the UDL. So UDL we have converted into point load, and where the point load is acting, point load is acting at the meet this span where the UDL is there, that is 60 kilonewton. So, and one more moment is given here. So, you need to show moment as it is, that is 100 kilonewton, whatever the moment is there. So, that moment you need to show as it is here. So, now all the things are ready. So, the thing is you need to apply the equilibrium condition. So, what is the equilibrium condition? Summation of Fx is equal to 0. How many horizontal forces are there? We are having the two horizontal force. One is Rax is the horizontal force, and there is a horizontal force that is resolved horizontal force, that is 200 cos 45 is the resolved horizontal force acting at point D. So therefore Ra is in positive direction. We know that the direction, this is positive, this is positive, negative and negative. So Ra is in positive direction and this horizontal component of inclined force is in negative direction. So therefore 200 cos 45. So by simplifying this, you are getting what is the value of Rax. Why we are getting the horizontal component? Because the given support is hinged support, therefore we are getting the two reactions. Therefore, Rax is equal to 144.42 is the value. So similarly, you need to apply the equilibrium condition, that is summation of Fy is equal to 0. So summation of Fy is equal to 0. So now you need to apply the equilibrium condition, that is summation of Fy is equal to 0. So how many vertical forces are there? You can observe the number of vertical forces. Rax is a vertical force moving upward, therefore positive, and Re is the vertical force moving upward, positive, and these 100, 60 and vertical component of this inclined force. So therefore you need to consider this also. Three vertical forces moving downward and two vertical forces moving upward. You just apply, you can see Re, Ry, 100 is coming downward, 60 is coming downward, and 200 sin 45 is the vertical component of the force, that is inclined force. So by that we are getting Re plus Ry is equal to some equation. So let us call that equation as equation 1. So now you need to apply the moment about A point. So moment at A is equal to 0. So you can observe in the figure moment at A. Just I will show you how you are going to take the moment. Just wait for a while. Okay. See here, number of forces are there. You need to take moment at A. Moment at A is equal to 0 here. So moment due to Rax and Ray about A point will become 0 because it is acting at this point only. Therefore, moment due to these two forces about point A becomes 0. So the remaining forces are there. So moment due to 100 kilonewton. So what is the moment due to 100 kilonewton about A point? What is the moment?
100 into 3.
100 into 3, correct. So that is 100 into 3 and it is acting in clockwise direction, therefore it is positive. Similarly 60. So you can observe, this is very important. Here UDL we have converted into point load. How you are converting? Magnitude into where it is acting, that is 20 into 3, 60 kilonewton is the converted UDL to point load, and where you need to show exactly at the center, so that is 1.5. So now moment due to 60 kilonewton about point A, how much?
60 into 4.5,
because force is here, right? our point is here, perpendicular distance becomes this, that is 3 plus 1.5, that is 60 into 4.5. Again, the direction is, in order to reach the point A, the load should come like this. So 100 also will should come like this, clockwise direction, therefore it is positive. So, and another vertical force you need to consider at this, that is vertical component of inclined force, it is acting at point D. So that vertical component is what? Vertical component is 200 sine 45, 200 sine 45 is our vertical component into perpendicular distance. Here you need to maintain the bracket. Into perpendicular distances, point D is here. We are taking the moment at point A, the perpendicular distance from here to here, that is 3 plus 3 plus 3, that is 9. So similarly, the another force is nothing but Re, that is support reaction. We are having Re, this Re, Re into perpendicular distances from here to here, and it is acting in the anti-clockwise direction. So in order to reach the point A, it should come in the anti-clockwise direction. So therefore it is negative, that is Re into perpendicular distance is 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, that is 12, is equal to 0. So in the entire equation, we are having Re is unknown here, so we can easily find out what is the value of Re. So once you know the value of Re, you can observe same minus Re into 12 and 200 sine 45 into 9, 60 into 4.5, 100 into 3, and along with that you need to consider whatever the moment they have given. So I have already explained in the previous problem, in the problem if they have given the moment directly, while calculating the moment you need to add that moment also. You can observe here, this is the clockwise moment, the direction of the moment is clockwise here. So therefore along with this equation, here you need to add plus 100. Why? Because the moment is given. So therefore by considering that moment also, you are getting the value of Re. Similarly, you just substitute Re in the equation 1, this equation Re plus Ray is equal to 301 is there. You just substitute, you will get the value of Ray. So this is how you need to draw the free body diagram and you need to find out the support reaction. So in the given problem, so what is the thing, based on the given type of the support, the reaction you need to write. So after that, by showing the reaction as well as the loads, you need to draw the free body diagram like this. After that, applying the equilibrium condition, summation of Fx0, summation of Fy0, and summation of moment at any point, you can take at A or you can take at the B point, is equal to 0. Is it clear? The same problem. Here the problem is there, then this is the free body diagram showing the number of reactions and load which is acting on a beam. So by applying equilibrium condition, you are getting the value. Is it clear? Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So another simple problem is there. So let me discuss this also. Then we can go for next. So here, the type of beam you can observe. So this is overhanging beam. So because you can observe here, so this is Ra support at A and this is Rb. They have already given, because Ra and Rb is given, means that is simply supported beam. So but here there is no support at this point. So since it is a beam, so there is no support at, so this beam is overhanging. Support is there at A. Overhanging means if the beam is extended beyond the support, such type of beams we are calling it as overhanging beam. So overhanging beam is given. So what is the question? along with the support reactions, you need to find out this distance. At what distance this 10 kilonewton force is acting. So determine, what you need to determine, distance x such that Ra and Rb are equal here. So that is, so Ra and Rb are equal for a beam as shown in figure. So Ra and Rb are equal, you need to determine what is the x distance. So by considering the support reaction, how you are solving, the same thing you need to consider free body diagram and applying the equilibrium condition here. And applying the equilibrium condition. So here UDL is there, as I have explained, UDL is there. So in order to convert this UDL, multiply this magnitude into this span, that is 10 into 2, that is 20 kilonewton. Where it is acting exactly at the center of the span where the UDL is acting. That is from point A, this is 1 meter and this is 1 meter. Clear? So now this is the free body diagram. No other type of forces are there. It's a very simple problem. Ra and Rb as the reactions are there. So what is the intention? You need to find out what is the x value. So given condition is what? Ra is equal to Rb. So they have given in the problem itself, since Ra and Rb are equal here. So applying the conditions of equilibrium, so there is no any horizontal forces are there in this beam, only vertical forces are there. So therefore, what is the condition you are considering? You are considering summation of Fy is equal to 0. So simple thing, Ra and Rb moving upward, therefore it is positive, 30 coming downward negative, 20 downward negative, 10 downward negative, along with that this 20 also, that is UDL, that is also coming downward, that is UDL converted into point load. 20, 30, 20 and 10 kilonewton, you can observe, 30, 20, 10 and 20 kilonewton, all are coming downward, therefore it is negative. So what they have mentioned, Ra is equal to Rb, therefore instead of Rb you are considering Ra only, therefore it is 2Ra, 2Ra is equal to 80, thereby we are getting the value of Ra here. So value of Ra. So now Ra and Rb value we have obtained. Then now the thing is finding out the x distance. So in order to find out the x distance, you need to take the moment. So that is, you need to take the moment at point A. So let us see what is the moment at point A. So here moment due to Ra is become 0, and moment due to this 10 kilonewton is exist. So just I will write what is the moment. So moment about point A, just I am writing here, that is 10 into, just I will write here, 10 into 1, that is moment due to this converted point load. 10 into perpendicular distance is 1, then 30 is there and it is clockwise, all are coming like this only, therefore it is clockwise, all moments due to downward forces are clockwise, and Rb is anti-clockwise, only one force. So then similarly 30 into perpendicular distance is 2, you can observe in the figure, 30 is here, perpendicular distance is here 2, and 20 into perpendicular distance, that is from here to point A, that is 3, that is 20 into perpendicular distance is 3. Similarly Rb is in anti-clockwise direction, so therefore I am writing Rb as a minus, minus Rb into perpendicular distance from Rb to A is nothing but point A is here, Rb is here, perpendicular distance means from here to here, 4 plus 1 plus 2, that is 7. Clear? So then another force, 10 kilonewton, 10 is here, point is here, that is total distance. So total distance means from here to here we are having 7 meter plus x. So therefore plus 10 is the force into perpendicular distance is 7 plus x. 7 plus x is equal to 0. 7 plus x is equal to 0 here. So you can observe here 20 into 1, 20, 30 into 2, 20 into 3 minus 40 into 7. So that is RB value is 40. So therefore minus 40 into 7 plus 10 into 7 plus x is equal to 0. So thereby we are getting the x value as a 7 meter. So here only the thing is writing the number of reactions, applying the equilibrium condition and finding out what is the unknown force which is given. So this is regarding the simple problem on the support reaction. So let me discuss some more problems in the upcoming videos.